Welcome to the presentation of this low-cost, non-invasive thermotherapy device, the HEPAC we want to do in Pakistan. Cutaneous leishmaniasis is one of the leishmaniasis forms, which is a neglected tropical disease, which is transmitted by the sandfly. And the cutaneous is obviously the cutaneous form which is affecting the skin and gives severe skin lesions and ulcers. It is affecting worldwide around 1.5 million patients per year globally, and mainly in South America, Middle East, North Africa, and Central Asia. One country where it's endemic is Pakistan. And here in the, in the this area is the Leishmania tropica, the species. And in this area is Leishmania major, and in the rural and the provinces of Sindh and Punjab. So here, it is not a health priority. It's non-fatal, and it's also self-curing, disease. So we are not quite sure about the numbers, but the estimated is 22 to 36,000 patients it's affecting in Pakistan. The next picture, you will see a little bit what it looks like. It is, in the end, self-curing, but the reasons to treat this disease makes it quite clear on these pictures. You see very harmful lesions, which causing a lot of scarring tissue, and of course, stigma. Also, when you leave them untreated, they will be an reservoir in the community, so for further transmission to other patients. The mainstay treatment is by very expensive antimonials, which is given by daily intramuscular injections for 3 weeks, or biweekly very painful intralesional injections for 4 to 6 weeks. So there is another possibility of treatment, because this treatment is not available in the governmental hospitals because it's very expensive, but the patients, they are able to get this treatment on local market or maybe black market. They can buy it there for very high cost, for around $5 to $10 per ampoule. So you can imagine that it's misuse and underdosing risk is very high. And well, there are other alternative ways. It might be thermotherapy, but that's delivered by a very expensive machine, the Theromed, by radio frequency. But also there have been a few small pilot studies being done with this simple heat pack, which is called the handheld exothermic crystallization thermotherapy device to treat this cutaneous leishmaniasis. It seems very affordable because it's only $2 per pack, and it's safe and very easy to use as well, because you can also reuse it by heating up in boiling water. So it is being studied in another province in Pakistan, in Sindh, and there it was very effective, of 83%. So we want to do in another area, another province, Baluchistan, where MSF has a project. We want to do a larger study to be able to establish further evidence that it's safe and effective, and also a feasible feasible treatment way. And also because it's very easy, and we could, if it's effective and safe and feasible, we could maybe roll it out into the peripheral level so that also other patients can have access to this treatment, and because we can use it then in the small health clinics. So that's what we did. We had a sample size of intended sample size of 317, and we treated all the patients for 3 minutes for 7 days in a row, and all the patients, they came for follow-up for up to 6 months, 15 days, 30 days, 60 days, 3 months, and 6 months after the start of the treatment. We measure the temperature because it needs to be the temperature of 52 to 53 degrees Celsius with this infrared thermometer. And all the patients with a parasitologically confirmed CL, who signed informed consent, very important, were included. And excluded were all the children under 10 years old or patients with a lot of lesions, more than 5 or large lesions, or patients with uncontrolled diseases, chronic diseases, immunological disorders, or pregnant and lactating women, we also excluded. And we collected some blood samples for species identification. Now, this is what we studied, effectiveness, safetyness, and feasibility. We made pictures from all the lesions on each visit that the patient would come. And of course, we monitored adverse events and if it was acceptable by the community, if they will be happy with this treatment. The results, we found that the species we have here is the Leishmania tropica, which is a bit as expected. What we did not expect is that more than 80% of the patients after 2 months were or increasing in size, deteriorating in signs of inflammation, or they did not improve anything after 2 months. So we suspended the study, and we tried to analyze what could be the cause, but we didn't find any procedure errors, or we did everything as the same as in the successful study in SINT. So therefore, the final failure is 94.6%, with only 3 patients that really got cured after 6 months. And because they were not healing, we found a high high percentage of patients with a secondary infection. The next slides, I'm going to show you some of the patients from the study, and it makes it quite clear, I think, why we had to suspend and stop the study. This is one patient on the face. This is also very striking, very, very obvious. Why we had to this? So this is on the baseline. So this is on the day, and this is after 1 month. This is after 2 months, and they are a few days later when we really got the infection very heavily. This is on the face and on the wrist again. So here you can see that the moment they got exited, you can see that on this graph. So with the median days of follow-up is after 2 months. Median days is 45 days. You would almost forget that that it was very, that it, the adverse events were not really severe. We didn't, the only thing we saw was quite some redness, but it didn't last for very long. We didn't see any burns. It was, the pain was, it was painful for the first minute, but after it got less. Very easy to use, and So then, what could be the reason? Well, the only plausible reason we could think of, one of them, is the species, the difference in species, because in our study we found the Eutropica, which is already known to be less heat sensitive and more difficult to treat with the anti-Lasmanian drugs. Also, it takes much longer to heal, if it heals at all, because it also you can develop into a chronic form. And the L major, which was the very likely the possible species in the SINT study, it's less easy to treat, and it's the time for healing is only within 6 months. So the other study was, the follow-up time was also 6 months, so it may have biased in that study that all the patients, they got cured due to spontaneous healing, like what has happened with our three patients who got cured. Another thing is that maybe it was not hot enough to penetrate the skin. So yeah, then what's next? It's nothing but next. We need to find another solution to treat this terrible, terrible stigmatizing disease, which is patient-centered. We had talked about it earlier, and of low cost, because this heat pack was only $2, and the other treatment is very expensive and painful. And if we want to make a success from this heat pack, then we maybe can find any more research in L major endemic areas. Well, I need to thank the whole team in Quetta who have been doing this study so well, and also, of course, the capital team and headquarters. Thank you very much.